On this episode of What's a Scoop Kids Bible News, join us on a cross-country road trip where we learn what it means to step out in faith. We're traveling by faith to the East Coast.
You get to spend 19 whole days in this.
There will be some ups. Some downs.
It was really horrible because I threw it up in someone's house.
And some all around. Plus, check out our exclusive interview with Ken Ham, the creator of the Ark Encounter.
Mr. Ken, what were you like as a kid?
Oh, me? I was really cute.
Get the scoop on these and more on this episode of What's a Scoop? Kids Bible News.
Hey guys, we're filming a very special episode of What's a Scoop.
We're going on a road trip!
I set my mind on a treasure map that God gave me for life. Though I cannot see the reward with my eyes, I'll follow His directions and believe Him over me, and know that He is my protection, though there's reasons to doubt. I'm stepping out with or without doubt, following You. In faith to a brand new place to see what You'll do. Guide me with Your truth. And as I go, I will rest my trust in what Your word has shown, knowing that there's hard times as we hit the road. I'll follow Your directions and believe You over me, and know that You are my protection, though there's reason to doubt. I'm stepping out with or without doubt, following You. Moving out in faith to a brand new place to see what You'll do. Guide me with Your truth.
Though there's trouble all around, I will choose to shout.
I will trust You. While there's breath inside my lungs, fill me with Your love.
I will trust You.
If perfect love casts out fear, I'll be fine, 'cause You are here.
I'm stepping out
with or without doubt, following You.
Moving out in faith
to a brand new place to see what You'll do. I'm stepping out with or without doubt, following You. Moving out in faith to a brand new place to see what You'll do. Guide me with Your truth.
What's the scoop?
Kids Bible News.
Oh, what's the scoop?
Kids Bible News.
What's the scoop?
Kids Bible News.
Oh, what's the scoop?
The founders of this country were made up of people who left their homeland in faith to flee tyranny.
They washed up on the shore of the East Coast with a dream to worship freely without the constraints of an overreaching government. By faith, they came to an unknown land without having any idea of what the outcome would be.
I'm not gonna lie, I have no clue what we're talking about.
In a similar way, we're traveling by faith to the East Coast as well. Maybe not for the same noble cause as them, but still to exercise faith in going to uncharted territory and to show you what the Bible describes as stepping out in faith.
I kind of like this pioneer costume.
We're such homeschoolers.
Join me to check out the rig that we'll be hauling all across the country. Let's check it out.
Hey everyone, we get to spend 19 whole days in this. Check it out! This is called a cyclone. This is Mom and Dad's room, where they sleep. Here's the bed, shower? The bathroom. This is a teeny bathroom, but perfect size for me. This is the kitchen. Here's a sink. Here's the fridge. I'm gonna open it. This is a couch, but it turns into a bed for me and River at night. Come with me over here. This ladder leads to Tatum's bed. Check it out. I tried to sleep up here, but my mom and dad won't let me. Come on, let me show you one more room. This is Grandma and Grandpa's room, and it has a bed that comes down. But when they're not sleeping here, they use it for storage. Let me show you how we move this thing. My grandpa pulls it with this big truck. Hi, Grandpa.
Hi, baby.
Hey, Grandpa, is it hard to move this around?
It's not hard, but it's a lot of responsibility to make sure you do it right.
Cool. Well, that concludes our tour. I hope you had a fun time checking it out.
First up on our venture in faith was to take the 6-hour drive from California to Arizona.
Early morning, drawing pictures, rolling hills and mountain tops.
In Arizona is where we met up with our grandma and our grandpa, who joined us on the journey. From there, we were off.
I can see the clouds rolling. I can feel the winds, they try to shake me.
We're here in windy New Mexico and continuing our venture in faith. It's crazy out here.
I can feel the waters rise.
From windy New Mexico, we traveled to the mountains of Colorado. While here, we stopped at a place called Cave of the Winds, a giant park that hangs off the edge of a mountain. There are multiple activities to enjoy, like a giant slide, a ropes course, and a tour through real caves.
Join us as we check out some underground caves.
This is the largest room in the cave, and as we go on through the tour...
The cave had a bunch of these things called stalagmites and stuff, and it looked really cool. Grandma was nervous because she didn't want to get claustrophobic.
To go on the battle pool that launches you out over the canyon.
There's a ride, and it's basically something that has two seats, and you just get pushed off the mountain, and it's like a zip line. Before, there's just a little gate, and then they opened it, and you went off the mountain. I was actually really scared just because it just looks really scary. You're like over all of the canyon, and you're just in this little seat.
There's like a real big heavy thing on like couple like of strands of string.
Are you scared, Legs?
Not really.
When I was like in the line, I had like this, my tummy feeling like I'm really excited.
River, you scared?
Yeah. Hey, buddy. I was really scared and I didn't want the thing to break.
It's really fun. It doesn't go extremely fast, but it goes at a good speed. So you can see the whole mountain and everything, and you're just above it all.
Was it fun? Was it scary?
Yeah.
I was really happy that I did it, and I wanted to do it again.
My hands are so cold.
Lakin, what are you thinking? You're scared?
I thought it was very fun when I got on it. I saw like down by my feet and it looked really pretty.
What do you think, Legs?
So fun.
How was it?
Yeah. Scary.
Yeah, it was horrible. I loved it.
Our last step of faith at Cave of the Winds was a high one. We hit the ropes course for some fun climbing over a huge cliff.
Woo!
To close out our time in Colorado, we checked out the Focus on the Family Visitor Center. Focus on the Family is a ministry that gives counsel and resources to families. They also put out awesome radio shows and movies for kids. Our What's the Scoop show was actually featured in one of their magazines. We got to see the characters and scenes from the shows come to life, as well as enjoy a three-story slide. Our time in Colorado was a blast, and before we left, we got a little surprise.
Ooh, snowing.
If there's one thing I snow, is it snowing.
Missouri is a place where there's a lot of things going on. We went to museums and shows.
There was a bunch of rides. When you went up close, there were a bunch of go-karts.
I looked at that Ferris wheel and it was really scary, but I tried to persevere and I got on it and I was at the very top and I looked at all the stuff and I'm like, wow, that's a lot of stuff.
There was this wax museum, and it was all these celebrities made out of wax. It kind of weirded me out.
In this last picture, we were all in the amazing Titanic Museum. But what you probably can't tell is our mom was really sick. It took every ounce of her energy to even come. She even had to be wheeled around in her wheelchair. To understand this more, let's rewind a little. 1 week before our trip, our mom had a bad relapse with an illness she struggles with that makes her really dizzy, that makes her unable to walk long distances, or sometimes not at all. She struggled with this before we were even born. To leave for this trip in the first place was a big step of faith. Leaving home and traveling the country in an RV isn't exactly the best situation when you feel sick. But she trusted that the Lord would take care of her and moved forward anyways. It takes great faith to not know how something's gonna work out, and this was a big something. Unfortunately, this was the part of the trip where she was her sickest.
Branson, Missouri was a really fun place and also a difficult place too. We did so much fun things, but my mom was really sick, probably the sickest on the trip.
We got to go to a couple plays, but my mom couldn't go. She had to miss out on everything.
I feel really bad for her, and I keep on praying for her. It was really fun when Grandma and Grandpa like taked us because Mom was sick, and they were really nice to us.
Me, River, and Lakin and my grandma and grandpa all together. It was really fun. It was just great being together.
All that being said, if you don't see much of her, now you know why. But hang on tight, there might just be a happy ending.
Just like our adventure in faith, the pilgrim's journey wasn't a cakewalk either.
Their travels included sickness, hunger, and even death.
Oh, that's a little more intense than what we went through.
From the ship ride over to getting settled in the land, trials plagued the pioneers.
But still, they persevered.
The question that comes to my mind is, if someone is stepping out in faith and trying to trust God, then why are there so many trials to follow?
Shouldn't things go smooth if God is on our side?
Keep watching to find out.
Faith has tremendous power connected to it, but is very misunderstood.
Huh? The Bible says in Hebrews 11:1 that faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
What in the world does that mean?
Just like our eyes and ears are the substance that tell us about the physical world around us, so too, faith is the sense that gives us evidence of the invisible spiritual world that exists.
Hebrews 11:6 says that without faith, it's impossible to please God.
The question for us is, how do we please God by faith?
We please God by doing what he tells us to do, even if it goes against what we want to do.
Noah stepped out in faith when he built a giant ark. Not because he wanted to, but because God told him to. To the people around him, he probably looked like a fool. It might not have made sense to him, but he did it anyways. And because of his faith in God's word, we're here today.
Some might be scared to step out in faith for fear that they might make a mistake. Some might wonder, does God really want me to do this? Or did I just think this up?
There are three things to ask yourself when stepping out in faith. Number one, does what I'm doing go against God's word, the Bible? Number two, does the thing I'm doing promote the gospel? And number three, have I prayed about it?
These are some good starting points to help guide us into our step of faith. Know this, stepping out in faith is almost always hard. But as we stay in connection with Jesus, no matter where we go, we can be sure that God will direct us in our path. And if we go a wrong way, he's very good at redirecting our path. It's better to step out in faith and obey God than to live a life of fear.
Although things were rough with my mom's sickness, still we press on towards Kentucky.
I've got peace like a river, flowing from the heart of the giver.
Well, in Kentucky, we met up with our great-grandma and our great-aunts, who flew in from Arizona. First up, we went to the Creation Museum.
When we got to the Creation Museum, my mom could move a little bit more, but she still had to be in a wheelchair.
In the Creation Museum, there was an explosion of creativity.
There were so many different things. There was like dinosaurs and animatronics. There were shows.
We watched these shows and we had to put these really cool glasses on. The movie was all about God's creation. He made all the stuff.
Unstoppable fountains, a source that never will run.
You really got to see an amazing display of biblical creation. Next up, we checked out the Ark Encounter. The Ark Encounter was mind-blowing. To see the actual size that the Bible describes was amazing.
It was really big. It was like the biggest boat I've ever saw.
I thought it would never be that big.
They did a really good job of showing how they could have fed the animals and how they kept life inside of that boat for that long.
Guys, we just got out of the Ark Encounter, and it was incredible.
If the world didn't give it to me, then the world can't take it away. I'm less impressed with this world's best.
We were all blown away by the incredible creativity and constructs of both the Creation Museum and the Ark Encounter. It must have taken incredible steps of faith to build something so big and in-depth. We got to sit down to do an interview with Ken Ham, the person who God used to think up these amazing parks. He's also a world-renowned author, an apologist, and the founder of Answers in Genesis. Thank you so much for having us, Mr. Ken.
We're making an episode on adventures in faith. How is it an adventure making the ark?
Well, it was a big adventure. We don't know how long Noah took to build the ark. That must have been an adventure for him to build the ark in a world where people had rebelled against God and they must have scoffed at Noah. And the Bible says he was a preacher of righteousness and he had to build this great big ship that God told him to build. And Noah, even with all the scoffing, did you know he did everything God commanded him to do? So there's a lesson we can learn from Noah to step out in faith. Well, we decided that we would reproduce Noah's ark because a lot of people today are just like the people in Noah's day. Along the way, the atheists, people who don't believe in God, they tried to stop us. But you know what? They can't stop what God wants.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Ken, what were you like as a kid?
Oh, me? I was really cute. And you know how I know that? My mother told me. I was really cute. But you know what? When I was a kid, we didn't have a Noah's Ark like this. We didn't have that. We didn't have a creation museum. But I had parents who loved the Lord Jesus, loved his word, and we were all taught about God's word, and that was really important.
How would you encourage young kids like us to step out in faith?
There's a verse of scripture, it's one of my favorite verses. It's 1 Peter 3:15. Always be ready to give an answer for people who ask you about what you believe. And we need to do what God has commanded us to do. And you know the first place to find out what God has told us to do? It's in his word. And you know what? I'm going to try something on you. You didn't know I was going to do this, but I'm going to ask you a question. What came first, the chicken or the egg?
Chicken.
Wow, that was quick you answered that. We go to the Bible, and he told us that he made the birds on which day of creation? Day five. Excellent. And he said he made the birds, and then he said to be fruitful and multiply, so the birds would have laid what? Eggs. So what came first, the chicken or the egg? You were right. The chicken. The bird came first. And so the first thing, you need to know God's word and what God's word says. And then you need to make sure you've got all these answers when people scoff at you for believing God's word.
Ken, thank you so much for letting us sit down and ask you some questions.
That's my pleasure.
What Mr. Ken said made a lot of sense. Any step of faith comes with hard times. Like he pointed out, Noah had to endure through many hard things to do what God wanted. And so did Mr. Ken. So maybe the trials that we were going through were actually normal. The Bible says that God allows trials so he could build character in us and to strengthen our faith. This encouraged us to press on in our journey.
Next up, we traveled north to Indiana to hang out and stay with some friends for the night.
When the river's dried up and no one's calling for rain, and I'm standing arms held high as the water hits my face.
While we were in Indiana, the miraculous happened. God was answering our prayers, and our mom started feeling better.
Always come through. You have not forsaken me. You are working all things for my good, even when I cannot see. I know.
The next morning, we were off to travel through Ohio and back down to our next stop, Pigeon Forge, Tennessee.
Every day I wake to the promise that hope is alive.
In Tennessee, we got to go to the amazingly fun Dollywood Amusement Park.
Everything's alright. You're like the break of the morning light. I know you always come through. You have not forsaken me. You are working all things for my good, even when I cannot see. I know you always come through for me.
Our time at Dollywood was unreal. However, you might have noticed somebody missing from this picture. Back in Indiana, the tragedy monster struck again. Although my mom was feeling better, Lakin started feeling sick.
I was at Indiana and it was really horrible because I threw up in someone's house in the bathroom and I did what Dad did tell the people.
You're feeling bad, babe. I'm sorry. Is your tummy hurting?
My family went to Dollywood, and I was staying with Grandma and Grandpa, and while I was sick, something crazy happened.
When we were gone, Lakin was really sick, but my grandma got sick too and had to go to the ER. We were really worried about her.
The next morning, Lakin and Grandma were on the ups, and so we pressed on to our final state, Virginia.
To our grandma and grandpa, since they needed to drive the fifth wheel back across the country, and we were going to fly home. We most definitely could not have done the trip without them.
For all the struggles, the pilgrims made it to the east coast of America to start a new life.
They set out to seek a land where they could worship free from tyrannical control.
It took faith for them to leave what they knew.
It took faith to endure sickness, heartache, and even death.
And yet, in the end, they overcame by faith, with the God of the Bible and the strength of the Holy Spirit.
And even though it was the end of their journey to a new land, it was only the beginning of their journey in faith for what God would do in the future.
Can we take this off now? This thing's really itchy.
After 5,000 miles, gallons and gallons of gas, the stomach flu, an ER visit, and one dizzy mama, we finally made it to the East Coast.
Our coast-to-coast trip.
There was a lot of trials along the way, from our mom getting sick,
and our family getting the flu, and throwing up,
to Lakin missing out on Dollywood, and my grandma going to the hospital.
The trials have been crazy.
But even with all of the trials, they don't compare to the incredible memories and happy moments that we've experienced on our adventure in faith.
With God,
He always has a way of taking even our hard times and helping us to see the good in it all. We can't fear following God because of trials, because that's what happens when you take any adventure in faith.
So thanks for joining us on ours.
Well, that's a scoop from God's truth to you.
See you next time!
If you have any questions about God in the Bible, send them to us. We will give them to Bam, our robot. Have your parent email the address below or reach out to us on Instagram.
Thanks for watching another episode.
Share it with your family and friends. Bye, guys!